Hello everybody and welcome to the electrical modeling part of this course. Here we will discuss how the results of characterization of the properties of materials and of optical simulations of a PV device are used to complete the modeling of the overall performance of the device. In fact, the electrical modeling of solar cells results in the estimation of its performance, expressed in terms of external parameters such as current, voltage, power, and conversion efficiency. The correct modeling of a PV device performance depends on the accurate characterization of materials and device properties and a rigorous optical modeling to determine an absorption profile in the device under illumination. The calculated absorption profile determines where and how many charge carriers are generated within the device. This is described by the generation rate of charge carriers. Properties of individual materials that form the device, such as conductivity, carrier mobility, doping concentration, and others, determine how many of these photo-generated charge carriers at the end contribute to electricity generation. This allows to quantify the final performance of our software model, both in terms of current density voltage characteristic and spectral external quantum efficiency. It is thus important that both aspects, characterization and optical modeling, are as accurate as possible. In this way, results of the electrical modeling describing the performance of the PV device can be considered reliable. Several different computational methods are available for the electrical simulation of photovoltaic devices. In general, they are or can be characterized by their approach in terms of geometrical description of a device structure and numerical modeling approaches for calculation of the device performance. When it comes to the geometrical description, one-dimensional or more complex two- or three-dimensional approaches can be selected. The choice depends on the material structure, interface morphology, and device architecture. One-dimensional models are in general simpler, but still effective enough to simulate solar cells with flat interfaces or randomly textured interfaces. On the other hand, multidimensional methods become necessary when a device contains multi-phase materials and interfaces based on periodic structures. Examples are periodic gratings that affect the absorption of light and special contact configurations that influence the flow of charge carriers in the device. When it comes to the performance modeling, there are approaches that are mainly used, and there are two of them. In the first one, the device is divided in a finite number of elements, semiconductor equations that form a mathematical description of the operation of the device are numerically solved for each of these elements and deliver results of variable parameters. From these variable parameters, the device performance is calculated. In an alternative approach, the entire solar cell is modeled with an equivalent electrical circuit consisting of various lumped elements. In the remaining part of this course, both the geometrical description and the various numerical modeling approaches of electrical simulations will be discussed. Pros and cons of different methods will become clear, and you will be able to select the best modeling approach for a solar cell you want to study.